This is Damien from Fucked Up. You're watching Absolute Underground TV.
Watching Absolute Underground TV. My name is Jen Book, and I'm here with Gene Hoglan. Hey, Gene, how's it going?
Awesome. How are you guys doing?
We're fantastic. It's a beautiful sunny day here in Vancouver, and you're about to play with Fear Factory tonight. How's that tour going?
Indeed, I am. Tour's going great. It has. It's been pretty nonstop. We've been touring since December, pretty ceaselessly, and myself, I was on tour for about 3 or 4 months before that, so by the time this tour ends in August, I personally will have been on the road for pretty much a year straight, and because I was doing Death Clock before that, and Meldrum, and all that sort of stuff, so yeah, this tour has been, it's been over to Europe like 3 or 4 times now, and this is our third U.S. run, and we did Australia, and South America, and all that sort of stuff, so the non-stoppity of it all has been pretty non-stop.
Wow, fantastic. So you must not get a lot of days off then.
I think over this entire year, I've had under 20, you know, probably closer to like 10 or something. And I've had like maybe 5 days at home, you know. The odd off day pops up, but there you don't see many on the itinerary, you know.
So tell me a little bit about this recently released instructional drumming DVD that you've put out called The Atomic Clock.
Indeed, it is called The Atomic Clock, and it is 2 hours chock full of Gene doing Gene. I show you how I get to do whatever it is that I do, and it wasn't intended to be merely an instructional DVD. I just wanted to film like a 2 hour sort of documentation, I suppose, of how I do what I do. And over the course of the editing, it kind of evolved into an instructional DVD because there was a bunch of extra stuff that I filmed as well, like comedy skits and just general retardation. So we kept those as extras. So hey, you've got an instructional DVD with extras. You know, you don't really see that too often.
Oh, fantastic. So now the other thing on the website is you've announced a worldwide clinic tour that goes along with this DVD. Any ideas about when that might be happening and where?
Well, that was part of my intent when I filmed the DVD, because when strapping kind of, you know, broke up or whatever in like 2006, I wasn't really sure what was going to happen with my career. Like if I was going to, you know, maybe I'll get a whole ton of phone calls from bands saying, hey, come down and jam, or maybe I would get none. So I figured I would just take the bull by the balls and plan my own stuff, you know, like, hey, I'm going to do this DVD, then I'm going to plan this clinic tour. And if nobody calls me, hey, at least I'm busy, I'm out there doing stuff. and I was rather mistaken about not getting phone calls. So I seem to have gotten calls from just about every band on the planet, and I have a hard time saying no. So I've been honkingly busy for the past, 4 years now that strapping's not been around, and trying to devote any time to, getting the DVD completed, for instance. That took a long time for me to complete it. I wasn't in a hurry, but still, it took a long time from filming until release, and therefore, this clinic tour that I announced a couple years ago, I still plan it. I still plan to do it, but it might not be a worldwide onslaught of it. It might be 3 weeks over here and 3 weeks over there, or 10 days here, whatever. I know Fear Factory is going to keep us pretty busy until the end of the year, I would say. And then hopefully next year, by 2011, things are, I'll have a good spot in my schedule to where I can, take a few weeks and go out and bring it to the people.
Instructional DVDs, not entirely metal, which kind of blew me away. So I was a little surprised by that.
Yeah, well, one thing I was, one other part of my plan was to kind of make this, an open audition for folks to check me out, knowing, a lot of people only know me as like super metal guy, and, he plays all the hauling double bass and all that sort of stuff. But I started off being a drummer, just a drummer. And, I've retained a whole lot of chops from those days. And since I, like many other musicians, I suppose, have a pretty wide selection of musical tastes. I wanted to show a bunch of the other stuff that I can do, and a lot of it, is not necessarily all metal. There's a couple of songs on there, one from my good friend Mr. Plow, and another one from an artist from Chicago named Jilly C. Neither of those songs are metal at all, and there's a couple of little drum solo type thingies that I do on there that aren't metal at all, a funk little section and a little shuffle section, because I'd like to show people that, it's not just all metal all the time.
The support team that's working behind this DVD, it's my understanding that your sister works for you and she's been really, really working it for you?
Oh yeah, I've, just all those times she used to pound on me when I was a kid and beat the hell out of me, I was like, I'll get you back someday. And so I put her to work for me, and she's really amazing, and I love her to death, and she's so wonderful to help me out in this regard, and we look after each other and we take care of each other, and so it's been pretty fruitful. And plus, I could pay her absolute slave wages and get away with it. Nobody else would work for this cheap, and I know she'll see this and she'll probably throw a brick at me for saying that, but hell yeah.
Cool.
Well, that's awesome. It always takes a great deal of support to be able to put any kind of a project like that together.
Absolutely, and I have gotten a lot of support from a lot of friends, like my girl back home. She also helped run the store, for the period where my sister is gone. And also, up here I have Rob Chickens Shallcross, who is, he runs Reversed Records, and he's the one who's taking it on up here. And, I'm definitely working with the kindness of very good friends, and a lot of people have stepped up and lent a really good hand, like Byron Stroud from Fear Factory. He acts as my manager much of the time, and he negotiates a lot of my deals for me. So, because I just want to play drums, that's it. I don't want to do any of the work, So just, I'll write the checks. You do the work,
Thank you so much, Gene. I really appreciate you. You've been watching Absolute Underground TV. My name is Jen Book, and we've been chatting with Gene Hoglan about his new instructional drumming DVD, The Atomic Clock, which will be available at HoglanIndustries.com, HMV, Long & McQuaid, and Reversed Records. Thanks so much, Gene.
Excellent. Thank you very much, guys. Hey everybody, this is Gene Hoglan, and I'd like you to check out my brand new drumming DVD. It is called The Atomic Clock. You can get it at HoglanIndustries.com and ReversedRecords.com, and you are watching Absolute Underground TV.
Absolute Underground TV.
Hi, I'm Crystal Coffin, and you're watching Absolute Underground TV. Now I'm here at the V Lounge with Auroch from Vancouver. Hi, guys.
What's up?
How are you? Hello.
All right, so you are on tour for your first day here, starting in Victoria, and you are playing with Archon Legion and Titan's Eve. So this is the debut of your release of your split with Agent Obliteration, also from Vancouver, and I have a copy of that right here. There's a couple of covers on the split. You guys are covering Morbid Angel, Chapel of Ghouls, and Ancient Obliteration is covering Abigail's Bitch, We're Gonna Kill You. What was the reasoning behind that?
I think we just kind of wanted to do something fun and different for a split. We also have a live song on there, one original one.
We wanted to put some things on there that you wouldn't find on the album, I guess. So we have a new song that isn't on the album yet. That should be on the next album, and we've got a live song, and we've got a cover. Just kind of like mix it up and, you know, give some variety.
We felt it was kind of like imperative to record that, really, because we released the album after we had kind of progressed beyond a lot of the material which was on the album. So on the new original one, Astral King, which we're all pretty excited about, it's got a lot more of everything. I don't know, it's different.
It's a bizarre mixture.
You also have a full-length release, Stranger Aeons, released this year. How's the response been to your first full-length?
I think it's been pretty good, actually.
We've gotten some really good reviews.
Yeah, not just in English either, also in French and Italian and Spanish. So,
also the other local bands we play with also seem to be very excited about it.
Yeah. It's always a nice feeling.
You guys have been referred to as Lovecraftian metal, and the experience of listening to your stuff is related as anti-human interstellar mind blast. Within that, a variety of metal styles, influence, and occult lyrics, what message are you trying to get across to your fans?
I don't know.
Sothoth is the ruler? I don't know.
There's a lot of... I guess we're a Lovecraftian metal band in the sense that our artwork and our imagery is heavily Lovecraftian.
But
the atmosphere of it is heavily Lovecraftian. But there's also the songs that have more message and aren't just based off H.P. Lovecraft's work are songs that are, deep or spiritual to us in other ways. So I don't know if there's a single underlying message.
It's about going fucking insane, dregs of sanity.
Being that you're from Vancouver, are you influenced by Blasphemy and the Ross Bay Cult?
Big fans.
Okay, so...
I don't know how much of like a black metal influence we have, but like that shows in our music, but we definitely appreciate it. We listen to it.
I listen to a shitload of black metal now.
Kool and I are big black metal fans, and I'd like to think that the vocals and some of the riffs on Astral King are heavily Dark Throne inspired.
You've made a statement, we seek the entrance to the gates outside. Do you believe that Victoria has one of those gates?
Possible.
Sure. Let's go with yes.
Yeah, I think so.
Well, we're known as the Satan capital of the world, so.
That's right. So we're very happy to be here.
Yeah.
That's what we're here to do tonight, really. So we're going to open the gates of Ishtar tonight with Titan's Eve and Archon Legion.
And, all right. You know, if hordes of Hellspawn come out and destroy the whole city, that'll just be par for the course.
How do you like playing the island?
It was great, actually. Last time we played here at the Chilean Metal Fest, it was actually a great turnout. It was really fun. All ages show put on by Darren as well. It was a great show.
Yeah, Darren's the fucking man, and all our experiences of playing the island have been with Darren so far. So so therefore, all our experiences of playing the island have been really positive. Darren's the man.
You got anything to say to your fans?
Yeah! Sorry,
that's about it.
We're Auroch,
and you're watching Absolute Underground TV!
Andreas Kisser from Sepultura, you're watching Maximum Underground TV.
Yeah. Give a brush.
Absolute Underground, sorry.
Hellfest in France, it's Absolute Underground TV. We're gonna rock it. Here we are, developing some Gouda and sausage sandwiches out of croissants in the morning here. It was a bit of a late night for me. I was out partying until about 5:30. We got roosters next to us as a form of wake-up device. I don't know if this is the best plan, sleeping next to roosters and death metal and generators on the other side, but I guess sleep's not really a priority for the next 72 hours, so just wing it, just figure it out as we go.
Yeah! Day 2 Hellfest. We got Twisted Sister, Immortal, Carcass, you name it, we got it. Tankard coming up on the stage right now. That's where we're going to go head to. German beer metal.
Merci beaucoup!
We've got Raven and Anvil in our future, and even Annihilator out of Vancouver, so Canadian contingent's getting big. So in the meantime, what can we do but explore, meet some new people, and probably drink a few more beers?
Yeah!
Some gassy beer.
Watching Absolute Underground TV.
Hardcore. I'm here with Pink Eyes, also known as Damien Abraham, frontman of Fucked Up. Are you doing any solo stuff right now?
No. Well, that's not true. I'm doing like some other bands, but I can't. I have no talent when it comes to like music. Yeah. So I always need to like rope someone to write songs in to kind of be my musical muse. Like, I've got a lot of ideas, but I need someone to articulate those ideas for me. So
what other projects are you in right now?
I have another band called Millennial Rain. Still kind of like off and on again, which is like an integrity worship band. And then I've got another band called Burning Field 4 with George from Alexa on Fire and Ian Keogh, drums of Tack and Black. And this guy, Chris O'Toole, who's also an Urban White. And we're working on our new 7-inch, but who knows when we'll finish it.
Nice.
And then that's it, actually. I only have those three bands.
Let's go.
in some kind of lawsuit with an energy drink company?
That was made up. That was our April Fool's prank. You know, it would be like funny prank. And so we invented this whole website, invented this whole company, this whole lawsuit.
A lot of people bought it.
A lot of people bought it.
You played a lot of tricks on people. Fake 7 inches.
Yeah. Yeah, because I think part of it is like, I don't think they're mean-spirited, you know? Like, I really honestly think that it's kind of fun and funny, you know? Yeah. And I kind of appreciate that. I really don't think we wanted to ever come off malicious. Like, we'd never be like, you know, we'd never play a prank like, oh, send us money, we definitely need money. And then it turns out there's no jam.
So let's talk about your new releases. You're the Ox.
Yes. Oh, well, dude. Okay. This song is called Brought Back by the Bulls. It's not like as long as You're the Pig, but it's longer than You're the Rat, so it's kind of finding the weird mix between the two.
You're the Lion, I hear, is done.
You're the Tiger.
Tiger.
We're starting to write, we finished writing it, we haven't recorded it yet. Okay. We haven't written the lyrics for it yet, so it's still like, I think like...
Waiting for the muse.
Oh yeah, it's weird, it's like, you know, like, I just want to check all these things off my dream list. You know, all these weird things that I never thought I'd ever be able to chance to do, it's just like... Might as well try it, you know? Living proof that you don't need talent to do it to be in a band.
This is Pete from Ace Perma. You're watching Absolute Underground.